A very warm welcome to everyone. A very good morning. We are back yet again with the session of Global Awareness today. But before we move on to the topic of the day, I'll be telling you something what is special about today. So today is International Dance Day. On 29th of April every year, International Dance Day is celebrated. Also, it was created by the Dance Committee of the International Theatre Institute, which is ITI, who is the main partner for performing arts of UNESCO. We did the full form of UNESCO as well. This day is a celebration day for those who can see the value and importance of the art form as dance and acts as a wake-up call for the governments, politicians, and institutions which have not yet recognized its value to the people and to the individual and have not yet realized its potential for the economic or the country's growth as well, right? So we should give importance to any and every kind of art form which we see around and not just only a few things which are related to it. So we'll now quickly begin with the session of today. All right. So as you can see, the topic for today is Plant Kingdom. We'll be studying a few things about the different things related to Plant Kingdom. Everybody is aware what a kingdom is. It's a huge place where we see different kinds of either the creatures or different kinds of humans, any and every kind of living being present in some or the other form. So what are we going to learn today? We will be learning about the vital functions of plants. We will understand the different categories of plants. We will understand what is photosynthesis and how is it important for plants. We'll also see and watch a video related to the gifts that we get from plants, that how are plants useful to us in almost every possible way. We will also study a little more facts about plants, in particular about only a few kind of new and different plants, right? So we begin with the plant kingdom now. As we all know that we share our planet Earth with plants and animals, with all other kinds of living beings, we have been sharing our planet with them. So that is the reason we have to give our share to the nature, and we have to build up a connection with all the plants and animals and maintain a balanced life. So these are the vital functions of the plants that you see around. First one is born, that a plant is being sowed in the ground and then it takes, like it grows up and then it grows, it interacts with the nature around. The bees, the insects come and sit on the plants. When this come and sit in the plants or on the flowers, the grains which are there inside of a flower, they stick to their body. So once they stick and when the insects fly away or travel away from that particular plant, they drop the seed somewhere else, in any part of the ground or any part of different area. So the seeds are dropped and then you see this process of reproduce, which is the plants grow again at some other place with those seeds. And yes, if it's a living being, it has to die one day. And again, the process will start from taking birth, that is sowing the seed. Now, what does a plant give us and what do we give out to plants? So when we breathe in, we take in oxygen, which is very important for us, for our respiratory system, for us to survive. And what do we give out to the nature? We give out carbon dioxide. So the plants have the opposite respiratory system to humans. They take in the carbon dioxide which we breathe out and they give out oxygen to humans to breathe in. So this is how the process works for plants. They take in carbon dioxide and they give out oxygen. But it is exactly the opposite for humans. We take in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide while breathing. Okay. So you see that most of the plants which we see around are green in color. The leaves are green. Most of the part of the plant is green except a few parts or except a few plants which are not green in color. So why is this and how is this green color present in them? So we see that the substance known as chlorophyll. I repeat, the substance known as chlorophyll is present in the plants, which helps it maintaining its green color. That is why this is the reason they have the green color, because there is a substance in them known as chlorophyll. So we'll see the process of photosynthesis. Just like plants need air to breathe in and respirate, they do need water to grow as well, and the sunlight to make their food also, and also to live and grow, just like we people, we humans also do. So what basically they do, once they get the water, the nutrients and everything from the soil and the sunlight from outside, the food is being prepared in the leaves of the plants. So basically they have very small pores in the leaves, which are also known as stomata, through which they intake the carbon dioxide, prepare the food, and then through the stem, it is transported to the other parts of the plant. So we'll study about the parts of a plant now. As you can see over here in the diagram as well, we have two parts of a plant. One is the root system and one is the shoot system. So the part of the plant which is below the surface of the earth, or which is below the ground, is known as the root system, which only and only consists of the roots. It doesn't have anything else below the surface of the earth or below the ground. So it is only the roots. But the other part of the plant, which is grown above the surface of the earth, is known as the shoot system. That means anything which is above the ground is called your shoot system of the plant. And it has four parts. One is leaves that we see, one is fruit, another one is flowers that we see, and another one is stem. So there are four parts in the shoot system, namely leaf, fruit, flower, and stem. And the part of the shoot system is, root system is only the root. So now we'll come to the next heading under this, another subhead, which is plant classification. That is, into how many categories plant can be classified, or plant kingdom can be classified. So there are five different categories of plants. First one is trees, second is shrubs, third is herbs, fourth is creepers, and fifth is climbers. I repeat all. First one is trees, second is shrubs, third is herbs, and fourth is creepers, and the last one is climbers. As you all can see here, you see a picture of a tree, of a shrub, of a climber, of herbs and creepers. So coming to the different categories and their explanation now. What are trees? So you see that amongst all these classification of plants, trees are the biggest type of plants on the earth. That means they are very huge, and in comparison to the other plant things that we see around, they are the biggest. We see shrubs now. Shrubs are plants which are like very small. They are very short-heighted, just found on the sides of the any of the parks or the grounds that we see where the plants are being laid on. And they are very small and they are weaker than a tree. That means they are not as strong as a tree, because a tree has a very strong bark or a trunk which is there to hold it, the complete thing. Then next we have, which is herbs. So herb is a small plant with a weak or soft stem. You must have seen herbs such as coriander, mint. All these are also known as herbs, which are very soft and delicate. Then we see climbers. These are the weak plants which cannot stand on their own. That means they need support of some or the other plant nearby, or some or the other object nearby to which they grow on. Like, you know, there is a plant called money plant. It is also known as a climber. It doesn't has its supports of its own. It takes support either of the nearby wall or the nearby plant where it is growing. Then we have creepers. Creepers, like climbers only, they are the weak plants that creep. They do not stand tall. The difference between creepers and climbers is this. The climbers that you see, as the word suggests, the climbers go tall and move in the upward direction as well. Yes, on the sides also, but also it can move upwards direction by growing. But creepers grow only on the ground, on the sides, either on the left or right. They grow only taking support of the other things on the ground level. They do not move up while growing in an upward direction. So now, what gifts do we get from plants, or how plants are so useful to us in our everyday lives? We'll be studying a few things related to that. So now we see first thing which is there, it is air to breathe. Yes, without plants, if there are no plants around us, we won't be able to breathe. So it is very important to keep plants around you, to have a very good natural environment around you, so that you have fresh oxygen every time to breathe from. Second, we have cereals, which is your everyday usage of the food that you eat. It can be in the form of rice, wheat, maize, or maize, which is also known in the form of corn, or even barley. Then we get vegetables and fruits also from plants. We do get pulses as well. Not plants are also in the form of the crops which are grown by the farmers. So they even grow the different pulses, which can be like, for example, chickpea, lentils, kidney beans. We do have edible roots from plants like radish, carrot, turnip. They grow under the ground, but these roots are still edible. We can eat these roots. So these are known as edible roots. Then we can eat certain leaves also of the plants, namely cabbage, lettuce, and spinach. We also get different kinds of seeds from the plants, which can then crushed and are converted into different kinds of oils. First one is your mustard seed. Second is your coconut seeds. Then we have ground nut seeds. And fourth one is your sunflower seeds, which when crushed and converted into oils, and then therefore these are used in our daily usage for cooking as well. Then where does the sugar come from? Sugar also comes from the sugarcane tree. Also, we have the plants for coffee beans and tea leaves also. So it's basically in everyday usage, whatever we eat and drink, we mostly get the things from the plants. We also have certain medicinal plants. What do you mean by medicinal plants is that certain plants have medicinal qualities, that we have natural medicines coming from them, which help us in some or the other treatments. Then we have wood. Also, we get from the bigger barks of the trees, which are there, which are very strong for making up the furniture. Then where do we get the rubber from? So rubber is extracted from the rubber tree, and it is extracted in the form of a latex. That means a white color substance which is scrubbed off from the sap of a rubber tree. So there we get the rubber. Now, where do we get the clothes that we wear in summers, which are made up of cotton? So those are made up of cotton plant, which when converted in a factory into fibers, and then they are built up as a yarn over there, and then they are converted into different kinds of clothing items. Also, we use certain plants for decoration purposes also. Flowers and plants, both of the things. And also, plants provide shelter for humans and animals. That means whenever they need shade in the summer time or the summer season, they do get shade and shelter also. Now, we'll watch a video related to how we get different things from plants in the form of a story.
Why do you love plants so much? Well, I love you too. But I help you so much. These plants don't. They do a lot for me. I have never seen them do anything. They can't even move. We all depend on plants directly as well as indirectly. Of course not. They depend on us for water, manure, etc. We depend on plants for a lot more. What do we need most to live? Air to breathe. Oxygen, to be precise. Yes. Plants give out oxygen in air. Oh, sorry. I did not get it. I will explain this to you. Go on. During photosynthesis, yes, that's the process which plants use to make food. Very good. I've learned it on makemegenius.com.
During photosynthesis, carbon dioxide diffuses into the leaves through pores and then enters the cell. In the cell, it diffuses into the chloroplast, where it makes oxygen and sugar in presence of light.
Also, thus plants give us the necessary oxygen to green and remove the carbon dioxide from air. Okay, that's the point I give to plants. What else? What do you eat? Cereals, veggies, fruits. Cereals are our main food. Plants give us cereals. Examples of cereals are rice, jowar, bajra, barley, maize. Do popcorn also come from plants? Popcorn comes from corn when it is heated. Corn comes from the maize plant. This is news to me. Some plants give us pulses like dry beans, pinto beans, kidney beans, and navy beans, dry peas, lentils, and others. Pulses give us proteins necessary for our development. Yes, you are absolutely right. What about veggies? Plants give us vegetables too. We eat the roots of some plants like radish, carrot, turnip. Did you know we eat the stems of some plants? Is that so? Yes. Celery, arvi, and elephant foot yam are the stems we eat. Oh, celery is a stem. We also eat leaves of some plants like cabbage, lettuce, and spinach. That's interesting. Yes, and bottle gourd, pumpkin, and cucumber are the fruits of plants. We eat them as veggies. Yes, but they are fruits. Also, we eat fruits like apples, bananas, oranges, grapes. Yes, these fruits are eaten as fruits. And do you know the oil in which mommy cooks food? Don't tell me they too come from plants. Yes, the seeds of plants like sunflower, coconut, mustard, and groundnut are crushed to obtain edible oil. And did you know that chocolates you love so much also come from plants? Don't say that. Yes, the cocoa seeds are crushed and mixed with sugar and flavors to make chocolate. Okay. And what's even more interesting is that the sugar which makes everything sweet, that too comes from plant. Yes, sugar comes from sugarcane plant. What else? Well, tea and coffee that mom and dad have also come from plants. Yesterday when I went to the park, mom put some awful smelling oil on my hands so that mosquitoes don't bite. Where does that come from? It comes from the eucalyptus tree. Also, most face creams contain aloe vera that comes from aloe vera plant leaves. Wow, that's cool! Also, many plants are used in medicines. Like tulsi leaves are used in cough syrups. Nice! Apart from food and medicines, we also use wood to make our homes. Also furniture, trunk of trees like shisham and teak are used to make furniture. And the doors and windows. Look at the tiles of the trunk. They are so big. You will be surprised to know that the tiles you are staring at also come from plants. No way. The tiles are made of rubber. Rubber comes from the rubber tree. We are all so much dependent on plants. Yes, the cotton shirt you are wearing also is obtained from a plant. Which plant? Fibers are made out of cotton plant's flowers. These fibers are used to make clothes. I will also tell one use of plants. Go on. Flowers are used for decorations in weddings. Yes, my favorite orchid. Not only we use trees to build our shelter, animals. Animals do use trees for shelter. Like birds make their nest on trees, and some animals live in tree hollows. Animals like deer, giraffe, eat twigs as their food. Yes, they are called herbivorous. Also, they too need oxygen to breathe, and that too comes from plants. So we should be nice to plants and keep them as our friends. Yes, my dear.
So what did we see in this video is basically that we should keep the friends, our friends, the plants as our friends in our lives. We should take care of them in such a good way that we never spoil them and always take a good kind of use from the plants instead of just spoiling and just plucking them or just de-rooting them from the roots which they have. So we should take care of the plants in different ways because these are our main source of everything in our essentials which they are providing us to our life. Now we'll move ahead to a few main specific and particular kind of things related to plants. First one is eucalyptus oil. So it is one of the oils which is used in skincare, which is used as a medicinal purpose. So it is obtained from the leaves of the eucalyptus tree. So we have certain parts of a plant through which we obtain a particular thing. It's not like the complete plant is having that particular purpose of giving that particular thing, but only a few parts of the plant which are used for extracting out certain thing which is beneficial for humans. So out of the eucalyptus tree, only its leaves are used for taking out the eucalyptus oil. Then we have rubber. So from the rubber tree, as you can see in this image, there is a scratch on the bark of the tree. So this is basically the sap of the tree. From when it is scratched, the layer inside this, the layer inside the bark has latex inside it. The white liquid is known as latex. And it is being extracted and then it is converted into rubber. And rubber, you all know, it's used for different kind of purposes in our life. Then we have cinchona tree and quinine. So quinine is one such chemical which is obtained from the bark of the cinchona tree. It's a tree named cinchona. And we obtain quinine out of it from which part of the tree? The bark of the tree. And quinine is a medicine which is used for treating malaria. So as you all know, malaria is a disease. So to treat that disease or to get rid of that disease, quinine is used. And where does it come from? From the bark of the cinchona tree. Then we have saffron. As you all know, kesar. So from where do we get saffron? You can see a flower over here, which has different parts. We can see its petals in different purplish blue color. Other than that, we can see three different strands or three different red colored long thin particles, which are known as stigmas. So these stigmas are the basically the part of a flower which is grown, and once it is dried, it is taken out of that particular flower and it is used as saffron. So this is where we get our saffron or kesar from. Then where do we get our tea from? We also get the tea from the tea leaves, from the tea gardens, and also from the buds of the plants whose scientific name is Camellia sinensis. So this is the scientific name of a plant whose buds produce these particular things which are there inside, which when crushed and then they are converted into different forms of tea. So we get tea from two different parts. One is the tea leaves and one is the tea buds. Then we have the next thing, which is cotton. So where do we get the cotton? You see a cotton plant over there. It is an enclosed bud first of all, but when it grows, it gives out cotton, which is then transformed into a yarn or a thread and then converted into a cloth. So the clothes we wear in summers to keep ourselves cool is made from the soft fluffy fiber that grows in a boil or protected cover around the seeds of the cotton plant. Now, just last few more facts about the various plants we'll study. So brinjal is also known by two more names. First one is eggplant, which is a very common name you must have heard. And second is aubergine. We pronounce it as aubergine. So these are two another names for the brinjal. Then we know that even ginger is an edible root. So where does it grow? If I call it a root, it grows under the ground or below the soil. So ginger grows below the soil. Then bees pollinate some plants. We just discussed in the starting that bees sit inside, or the insects sit inside of a flower. They stick their own parts of the plant, and then what happens is basically they do this. Then next we have is leaves are known as the food factories of plants. So where are the food production of a plant done? They are done in the plant, the leaves. So basically leaves are also known as the food factories. Then we have, what do plants use to make their food? They need water, they need sunlight, and they need the nutrients which are essentially provided to them through the soil. Then where do they intake their nutrients from? Since they are in the soil, they intake it from the roots. And the last point we'll study here is the carbon dioxide present in the air enters the plant through the small pores in the leaves, which are known as stomata, right? So these are a few things that about particular plants. Now we'll just quickly recapitulate whatever we have done. First, plants are essential for our survival or for our living. Second, plants are divided into five categories. Third, plants provide us with different things such as wood, fruits, vegetables, oxygen, oils, pulses, cereals, and etc. Then plants have five different parts. Plants make their food through a process called photosynthesis in the presence of sunlight, of course. The green colored substance present in the leaves is called chlorophyll, because of which we see the green color in plants. And plants breathe through small pores in the leaves called stomata. Now this is your home task. You need to find the name of the tree which is also famous or known by the name of village pharmacy, right? So there is a particular tree which is known by the name of village pharmacy. You'll need to find out the name of the tree, and we'll discuss it in the next class. Also, I have provided you with a link below. You need to see that how is the process from a cotton plant, from where a cotton plant is grown, till it is converted into a piece of clothing. You can watch this video for that, right? Now, if any doubts, anybody wants to ask, you can ask, and parents might share their valuable feedback on the given mail ID below, which is manavds@yahoo.co.in. Hope you enjoyed and learned something valuable with this class. And we'll end our session for today here, and we'll meet soon. So till then, everybody would take care and make a very good use of whatever time they have at home, and help your family as well, right? So thank you so much, children. Have a good day ahead.